The United States now has a new volcanic eruption. During the evening, on February 20th, 2025, while many eyes were tuned in to see if and when Iceland's next eruption would occur, an unexpected volcanic eruption happened at another volcano in a similarly cold climate. This occurred in the United States Aleutian Islands, where, at 7:26 p.m. local time on a populated island, an explosion was detected at the Atka Volcano. As the explosion occurred, and it's done. Yes, a single explosion occurred at this time, but it only lasted for 1.67 seconds. This marked a phreatic eruption, which, though incredibly brief, likely resulted in the generation of a minor ash plume that rose above the summit cone of the Korovin volcano. Although we do not know how high this plume went since it was obscured by low-altitude clouds, we can say that the plume was small and rose no more than 4,200 feet above the erupting crater, although in all likelihood the eruption plume was measured in hundreds rather than thousands of feet high. Phreatic eruptions are essentially the volcanic equivalent of a steam explosion which do not eject any lava. They still can be destructive and large in size, but this latest eruption was neither of these. Due to the eruption's small size, likely rating on the Volcanic Explosivity Index as a 1, the small town of Atka, centered 12 miles to the south, did not experience any adverse effects. As a result of what may have been only a one-off explosion, or what could be the beginning of a longer sequence of more similarly sized explosions in the upcoming days, although this is less likely, the alert level of the Atka volcano was raised from green to orange. You might be wondering why I said the Atka volcano instead of the Korovin volcano, and I will explain this distinction later in the video. I have a strong suspicion that some amount of ash was deposited on the southeastern portion of Korovin summit crater, perhaps a bit less than this image taken after a larger phreatic eruption which occurred in 2004. For context, the Atka volcanic complex doesn't merely consist of one central stratovolcano, which, much like the Three Sisters volcano in Oregon, consists of multiple separate stratovolcanoes. Atka consists of four stratovolcanoes and two satellite stratocones, with the four stratovolcanoes being called from oldest to youngest, Konia, Sirichev, Klyuchev, and Korovin. To potentially make things more confusing, some classification schemes actually consider Korovin and only Korovin to be part of a separate volcanic complex from the other three stratovolcanoes, while others consider it to be part of the same volcano. I personally think they represent two separate volcanoes. Korovin primarily erupts basalt eruptive products, while the rest of Atka erupts andesitic or dacitic eruptive products. These are fed by separate magma chambers at a depth of 2 to 5 kilometers or 1.2 to 3.1 miles below sea level. In historic times, 18 eruptions have been observed, 3 from Klyuchev, which last erupted in 1995, and 15 from Korovin. Both of these volcanic cones have large geothermal fields on their flanks, with nearly a dozen small areas which contain hot springs, carbon dioxide gas seeps, and/or fumaroles. The vast majority of historical eruptions at this complex were phreatic, like what just occurred, where groundwater related to its vast geothermal system seeped into its magma conduit and was heated to such an extent that one or more explosions occurred. 13 of 17 prior eruptions fit this description. Most of the overall eruptions also lasted under a day. 6 eruptions lasted longer and were a degree more explosive, while 2 were large enough to cause ashfall to fall on the city of Atka and send ash plumes to a height of 35,000 feet. It is unclear what exactly will happen next, but given Atka's history, life should continue as fairly normal with a low but still possible chance that more phreatic explosions will occur. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Michelle Hudsonhawk, for supporting my work.